What is up, alien army? I am Oculus, the alien next door, purveyor of esoteric lore. And today, our esoteric topic, we are going to be taking it esoteric, of course, and we're also going to be putting a more occult twist on today's topic. Okay, so occultism and esoteric knowledge, they are similar, but this is going to be more occult like so just letting you know, for know what you're getting into. And I do want to say that this was prompted by a recent download that I had actually yesterday and into today, so I'm filming this while it's still rather fresh. I am going to leave a timestamp if you want to skip ahead from my little disclaimer here, okay? So if you just want to get right into the video. But with this disclaimer, I do want to say that I am going to be talking about some archaic knowledge that's just known historically. I'm also going to be channeling some information, which is what prompted me to do this. And I am going to be touching on religion a little bit, so if any of these are triggers to you, then please just, you know, find another video to watch. I want everyone who views my channel and views my videos to have the most pleasant and comfortable experience, so I am just throwing that disclaimer out there for those of you who feel resonate, okay? So now, to get into my brief intro here, is I was having a conversation with someone, and a symbol, I guess a logo, in modern society was brought to my attention, and it just, I received some information from that, so that's where it was, that's basically where it came from. I'm going to try to get into that logo maybe in another video, but not at this time, because the video is just going to be way too long, and you guys know that I like to talk a lot, but I do feel that it's necessary to tell you that this is where the information came from for me. It kind of alerted me to something, and then I had been communing with some fourth dimensional entity, and I did not know what this entity was. And if you're familiar with my other videos, you are aware that I do say that the fourth dimension is not all negative or all evil or all sadistic or things like that, okay? There are positive energy beings there as well. I do have some videos which I can link below if you want a little more info on that. But essentially, I was told, it was conveyed to me that the being that was communing some of this info to me is a fourth dimensional entity, okay? And there, this individual has no body, does not have an interest in having a physical human body, okay? This being is nameless to me, okay? Because they are a whistleblower for the satanic mafia. And yeah, so I know it does sound a little out there, but this is how it was conveyed to me, so I am going to speak my truth, that, you know, this is my channel. So that's where the information came from, just to let you know. And a lot of it I did channel, and then I conducted my own research just to get sort of like the historical facts so that I can give you guys the most accurate information, okay? Historical information as well as things that I did channel. And again, this is from a nameless entity who is a whistleblower for the satanic mafia, okay? So now we're gonna get started, all right? So for those of you that just skipped right to this time stamp, hello. We are going to talk about the definition first, when I'm going to speak about occult and mafia, because this is it's pretty relevant to the topic that I'm going to be discussing today, okay? And I don't know if all this is going to fit into one video, but just to let you know, okay, I will label this as part one, just because this is kind of the beginning. And so when I am speaking, at least in reference to this video, when I say the word occult, We're going to go by the definition of occult as an adjective, okay? And this means of, involving, or relating to supernatural, mystical, or magical powers of phenomena, or beyond the range of ordinary knowledge or experience, mysterious. And we will use the word mafia by definition relating to a closed group of people in a particular field having a controlling influence. Okay, so I'm just gonna let that sit for a second. And as I had previously mentioned, the whistleblower that I was communing with had given me a whole lot of different symbols, which I kind of pieced together. If you guys are familiar with the way that channeling works, it's, you know, sometimes there are complete sentences. A lot of times, especially if it's a new entity that someone is working with, they are going to give information that is in bits and pieces or symbols that you see or things like that. Okay, so long story short, this is a satanic mafia whistleblower, and I received the message about dark side of the moon and Saturn and Saturn's rings and all of that stuff, okay, just by seeing a symbol that I, you know, somewhere along my subconscious I recognized as what it is, okay? So I hope that didn't get too confusing, but anyway, so now today's topic, we are going to side-eye Saturn, okay? Which to me, this is my definition of side-eyeing Saturn, means essentially looking at Saturn for who he really is and who he is actually portrayed to be. Okay, now this is going to touch on astrological, astronomy stuff, and it's going to tap on occult and arcane wisdom and knowledge. Okay, so why is Saturn important to life as humans know it on Earth? Now, this is because Saturn is the final emancipator before crossing the threshold into utopia, Y-O-U, which is Christ consciousness here on planet Earth whilst still in a human form. Saturn is the furthest planet from the sun that can be seen with the naked eye, and there are many ancient accounts of Saturn actually being regarded as being the quote-unquote sun of ancient times, as Saturn was believed to be the main celestial body in the sky, and this was prevalent in Mesopotamian, Roman, and Greek civilizations, okay? And it is believed that a cataclysmic event occurred, something like an explosion that darkened Saturn up in the sky, and afterwards he took on a more sinister connotation, being called a negative force, or the old sun, the dark sun, or the dark lord. Now, as time went on, the Brotherhood of Saturn was born, and based on the ancient civilization's belief that Saturn was the dark lord, Saturn's reputation took another turn. Prior to the discovery of the outer planets via telescope, and the outer planets, in case you're wondering, are Uranus, Neptune, Pluto, it was believed that Saturn was the planet furthest from the sun because that was the one that they could see from their naked eye, which was the farthest away. Remember, they're not using telescopes, right? And therefore, it was being restricted from the sun's rays more so than the inner planets, thus being called quote-unquote dark. That, coupled with its already quote-unquote dark lord association, caused Saturn to be affiliated with dark energy, dark forces, etc., etc. Now, this is where the black cube was born. If we look into this hexagonal shape that appears on Saturn's north pole, we can see that a hexagon has six sides, and also the number six will be especially important to remember regarding Saturn as we proceed along, okay? So the hexagon looks like a flattened cube, a black cube, because the black indicates the darkness, as Saturn was considered a dark planet at this time. and it's incorporating the ancient beliefs about Saturn into modern symbology. Okay, so we have the ancient beliefs of Saturn being the dark planet now, and also incorporating it into modern symbology, which is the cube. Okay, so this black cube is actually seen all over the world. It's prevalent on different continents, different countries. I mean, like, this black cube is all over the place, okay? And it is also prevalent in the three major monotheistic religions on Earth at this time, okay? So the three major monotheistic religions are Islam, Judaism, and Christianity, okay? And the black cube is represented in all three of these religions, okay? And the black cube is actually a sigil for the cult of Saturn, okay? And we'll explain more what a sigil means in a second. But first, we are going to say that in Islam, the Kaaba, and I apologize in advance if I pronounce any of these words wrong, but you know, I'm doing what feels right, okay? So the Kaaba is believed to be the place where the sacred world intersected with the profane, the place where heaven and earth meet. Now in Judaism, the tefillin consists of three parts, and one of which is a black cube, which is worn on the head. And this black cube is containing sacred scrolls. Okay, so now moving along to Christianity, the cross is the most recognized symbol in Christianity. And if we want to look at a cross and fold it up, it becomes a cube. Okay, so we have three examples of the cube in the three most popular monotheistic religions on Earth. Okay, is that a coincidence? Are there such things as coincidences? All right, so in essence, the three most prevalent monotheistic religions are worshiping Saturn. At least they're worshiping the sigil of the black cube. Now, what is the significance of a sigil? A sigil, by definition, is an inscribed or painted symbol considered to have magical power. And if one is familiar with magic, a sigil is able to become charged up with currency just by looking at it. And the black cube of Saturn is not the only sigil of Saturn depicted here on Earth at this time. Take a look around you. Now, I mean a deep look, okay? An out-of-the-box look. What is Saturn most famous for? Any guesses? Ding, ding, ding. I'll pick you in the corner there. Raise your hand. Thank you. How about the rings? The rings of Saturn, okay? The rings of Saturn are sigils hiding in plain sight, and this is not religiously, as we went into religions just right now. These are other symbols which we're going to get to, which are still very prevalent just in plain regular society, okay? These sigils are hiding in plain sight, ready to be charged up by human currency. Just one glance will do. The recognition of these sigils on a subconscious level is actually embedded into the human DNA structure. Now, when coming into a human suit, human DNA is downloaded and encoded to the extent that most scientists do not even understand at this point. Did you know that 98% of human DNA is considered quote-unquote junk? Just because it isn't fully able to be understood? 98%, all right? 98%. What is residing dormant in there? Could it possibly be programmable DNA or even pre-programmed DNA? Why are there rings all over the third dimensional plane that are easily recognized by the masses? Wedding rings, rings as major brand identifiers, etc., etc., etc. Are they actually sigils left by an other source, waiting to be charged up by human currency? Are humans actually programmed subconsciously to charge up the sigils of Saturn? If so, for what purpose? Who are the engineers of these sigils? Why is the number 6 imperative in decoding Saturn's message? Now, in astronomy, Saturn is the 6th planet from the Sun. Saturn's north pole contains a 6-sided hexagram shape. And Saturn is the bridge betwixt the ethereal and the earthly. And if we take another look at Saturn's hexagram pole, we can also see a 6-pointed star with an upward-pointing triangle indicating the ethers and a downward-facing triangle indicating the material plane. Let's now look at the astrological association of Saturn. Perhaps we'll find some answers there. Now, in astrology, Saturn is considered to be the governor of time and karma, and Saturn is also associated with past lives and learning lessons. It is believed that once the quote-unquote restrictions of Saturn have been lifted, that a great awakening or enlightenment shall occur. That is, for those who actually awaken to the influence of Saturn. Saturn is the astrological deal-breaker, so to speak. He governs the material realm and creating material wealth and physical legacy. Once the material barrier has been broken by learning the lessons of Saturn, one is now free to choose their own destiny here on the material plane. Saturn is the conduit betwixt the ethers and the earthly. Does this sound similar to one of the meanings of the black cube that I mentioned earlier? The place where heaven meets earth. How about diving deeper into the esoteric astrological association of Saturn? Oh, well, you know what? We'll bring tarot into it too. I mean, why not, right? So, some things to keep in mind are that Saturn is the governor of the astrological sign of Capricorn. Capricorn's tarot card is the devil. In esoteric astrology, there are 3 crosses of human life experience: the mutable cross, the fixed cross, and the cardinal cross. As Saturn governs Capricorn, and Capricorn is a cardinal earth sign, the sign of Capricorn is the final emancipator on the esoteric astrological wheel of the cardinal cross. It is known as being the final step in human consciousness here on Earth, the point where full Christ consciousness, whilst in a physical body, is achieved. So again, we have Saturn symbology as the area in which the mystical meets the mundane, where heaven and earth commune, where true magic happens, where occult wisdom is truly recognized, understood, and put to use. So why would magical occult knowledge be associated with devil or dark energy? Could it be because those who have attained this knowledge do not wish for any others to achieve it? At the same time, are they the same beings behind the scenes of the Saturn sigils, getting their symbols of magic charged for free by unknowing earthlings? Is their auric field growing stronger by feeding off of the energy given to their sigils by humans? Are they manipulating Saturn, energetically and physically, for their own benefit and dominion over the third dimensional plane on Earth? Why is Saturn associated with the devil? Why are these sigils so important to getting charged for these other beings? What is the devil? Who is the devil? Who are these beings? Is the devil an individual? A group of individuals? Does the devil have its own mafia? Or is the devil an energetic vibration? does the devil organize and run its own mafia on the third dimensional plane? Now, these are some interesting questions, and we are going to allow you to ponder them if you so desire. That is it for the intro of this video, and part one. Well, yeah, kind of the intro. Introduction to side-eyeing Saturn. And we'll leave you off with that, okay? So as you can see, Saturn symbology is everywhere, and Saturn is astronomical, astrological, it's occult-ish, it's religious. I mean, Saturn is just all over the place, isn't he? So that was it for our little introduction. As always, it is our intention that those who are meant to resonate with the messages they find here resonate with them well. That is today's esoteric / occult chit chat. I am Oculus, the alien next door. Peace, good vibes, and namaste. Blessed because you are.